Good day, everybody, and welcome to this edition of High Heat, brought to you by Liberty Mutual. It is nice to have with us Moses Mussina, you and me, as we talk to you about what's going on as far as the world of baseball is concerned. The turn back time today, we figured that it warranted it because it's the 10th year anniversary, June 2nd, 2010, of the famous near-perfect game from one Andrews Galarraga, who did not get it because of the call by Jim Joyce in Detroit. With two outs in the ninth inning on that ground ball that Jason Donner hit for the Indians. Lots to do about it. Let's give you a look as far as where we stand with that particular game. That was Tigers, of course, at Comerica. Galarraga was a pitcher from Venezuela, making his fourth appearance of the year, his third start. And he obviously had tremendous control that night, a very good fastball. Alex Avila was the catcher. And he kind of mowed down the Indians throughout the night. Now, there were some hard-hit balls. And they had some opportunities, a ball that deflected off his foot. There was a ball in a short left field. I mean, there were some, you know, typical perfect game possibilities. There's always three or four of them where, in fact, you never know. It's the luck of the draw. But the one in the ninth inning is fascinating because a ball that Mark Muzulanik hit, remember him, out to deep center when rookie Austin Jackson, an excellent center fielder, made an over-the-shoulder catch. The great call on TV saying, Willie Mays. That came with one out in the ninth inning, and obviously that preserved that perfect game until Donald, who was a little hitter, ran well, a little left-hand hitter, hit the ground ball between first and second, and Galarraga ran to the bag, and everybody thought he was out by first appearances. It's a famous play. Everybody remembers it. And Jim Joyce, you know, a little bit like Dechinger, that kind of play in the 85 World Series on that ball that Orta hit. Dechinger, of course, had to live with that for the rest of his life. As a matter of fact, was the umpire in Game 7. Joyce, you know, made the call that, in fact, Donald was safe when, in fact, he was out. The famous call in the booth, and, of course, replays shortly thereafter, confirming that Joyce blew the call. Now, nobody on the field knew that at the time because, obviously, you got to run back into the clubhouse to see the call for yourself. And Joyce didn't even know either. Well, they get the last out of the game. It turns out to be a one-hitter. And, of course, the Tigers win the game 3-0 on that June day. They go into the clubhouse after the game. Joyce walks down to the umpire's room, and they press the button. He sees it, and obviously he realizes right out of the gate that he made a bad mistake. The Tigers saw the same thing. They had a pool reporter who was covering the game with the umpires, and the pool reporter knocked on the umpire's room's door. And obviously, Joyce said, bring them all in. Let me handle this. He was all upset, realized that he couldn't hide behind the crew chief. So all the reporters came in, and obviously he broke down. He was very, very upset. And obviously it was a call that he regret the rest of his life. It's funny, Leland, when the game was over immediately, you remember that famous scene when Leland was yelling at Joyce? On the field when Joyce was walking in the umpire's room. Joyce took that. But everybody took Galarraga's cue. He's the story here. He did a superb job of not going too crazy. They actually gave him a beer shower, even though they knew that it was a one-hitter historically. They did give him a beer shower. And, of course, Galarraga did a superb job of making sure that Joyce was taken off the griddle. Joyce that night went to go visit his mom, who lived down in Toledo, about a 45-minute drive from Detroit. And then the next day was a day game. Joyce was behind the plate, and everybody knew that he was going to get booed when the umpires came out of the wall there behind home plate. And great job by Leland, who understood this as well. And Leland said, Galarraga, why don't you go out there and turn in the lineup cards? He timed it in such a way that as soon as Joyce came out, Galarraga left for the pitcher's mound. And in the scenario, boos kind of became cheers. So, you know, in essence, it was really a tremendous job for baseball. It was a great deal of sportsmanship shown by everybody. Everybody knew Joyce was crushed by blowing a call. Galarraga handled it superbly. Leland actually had a cigarette and kind of relaxed with Joyce. Leland being that, you know, sort of an old throwback, realized that Joyce, who was an umpire from 1989 and was a good umpire, very good umpire, he knew that Joyce was hurting. You can make a mistake like that. This is obviously before instant replay. So everybody really, when you think about it, handled this great. It was actually good for the sport because it came across very well that everybody could put it behind them and move on. Now, listen, they have gone to the rules committee at the commissioner's office to see if they can get this court changed. And obviously, you can't do that because that opens up a Pandora's box of changing every bad call in the history of the sport. What do you do about the 85 World Series if you're just going to change this? So it's gone in infamy. It's going to be what it is. Obviously, today, this call would not have occurred. But in essence, it was actually the best thing that happened to both of them. Joyce is retired. So is Galarraga. Galarraga says, geez, I mean, when you get right down to it, if I pitched the perfect game, nobody would want to talk on anniversaries of this. And obviously, Joyce, now living in Oregon, kind of has said the same thing. Joyce would not turn down any interview request. If somebody calls him up on June 2nd, which I might very well do here on radio, if somebody calls him up, he'd give him an interview. And obviously, the same thing goes with Galarraga. He'd do the same thing. It was a very bad moment. It took away a piece of history for Galarraga. It's terrible that it was a, you know, listen, this is a journeyman pitcher who won 26 games in his career with a 4.78 ERA. So this is his one moment to shine, but in essence, he shined greater based on the fact that he handled it so great. And Joyce, you could tell how crushed he was by blowing a call. He comes across well here too. So it's a famous day. It's a famous night in the sport. It's a famous call at first base, but it's made baseball, and it tells you the greatness of baseball, the sportsmanship aspect of it. I think it's actually almost better in the long term that he blew the call instead of getting the call right. A lot of guys have thrown perfect games, and you can name them all. There's that great trivia question. Name all the folks who have thrown perfect games and everything else. You can do that, but name the guy who had the perfect game ruined with two outs and ninth and a bad umpire's call. Take you 5 seconds. Take you an hour to come up with all the 14 or however there how many be who have thrown perfect games. Take you 5 seconds to remember Galarraga's name of the Tigers. So on this date, on turn back time, that's what we go with here. Jim Joyce and Galarraga, Tigers on a night in Comerica Park, and where both sides made turn something bad into something good. That's where turn back time takes us on this day. We got more to do in the course of the week. Enjoy your next couple of days, and we will see you down the road. High Heat, brought to you by Liberty Mutual. Adios.